Hello ladies and gentlemen, how do you do? Welcome to this edition of Programming Wizards. Now guys, for today we shall look at something. We shall continue with the SQLite database tutorials, and today we're going to use, remember in the last tutorial we checked how to use SQLite, how to insert into a SQLite database, retrieve that data and populate a list view. Now today we shall do the same but with the grid view. Okay, now guys, this is what I'm talking about. Take note that if I click retrieve, these ones get retrieved right here. What about if I come add more data right here? For example, I come here, add something like this one, then I click save, the data gets saved. Now if I click retrieve, take note, it's here. If I click it, you can see it right here. Okay, and if I come, for instance, I add more data like these ones right here, I can even add plenty of data like this one, then I click save. Now if I come click retrieve, you can see our data right here. Okay, actually this grid view is being populated from our SQLite database, so that's it. You can see we are also handling events. If we click it, you can see right here we can get whatever's been clicked. Guys, that's it. This is what we're going to see, so join me, we'll get started. So first and foremost, obviously go and create your Android application. Come here, create Android application. Then once you've created your Android application, of course you shall have your main activity right here. But there I'm using Eclipse, you can also use Android Studio. There's really no much big difference. You shall have your main activity right there. For now we shall just leave it that empty. Then go to your XML activity main layout and just design your form, okay, just the way you want it. I won't be designing it right here because I want to this video to be shorter. Okay, I want to save you time instead of dragging stuff right here. Now this is just an edit text, this is another edit text. Of course these two are text views. This is the save button. When clicked, we shall save, insert into the database. When retrieved is clicked, we shall retrieve data from the database and populate this data grid, this grid view right here. I just have a text view just to show us that now if this is empty, now the user shall be able to see that the data the grid view shall be right here. I don't know why I like calling it data grid view, I'm used to C#. Now this is it guys. You can see here, this is my XML layout. Actually just button edit text, my edit text right there. So it's just my text view, my header text view and my grid view. I just put them inside the linear layout, and then I've included everything in the parent layout, relative layout. That's it guys, that's our XML layout. Now the next thing, I shall need you to create a new class. Just add a class to your project. For me, mine is here. I've just called it DB adapter. It shall be empty, okay. No, this one, this class shall encapsulate all our database operations, so that when we come to our main activity, we just call methods of our DB adapter and insert into our database or retrieve data from our database. Remember, of course, we are dealing with databases now, and the first thing when you're dealing with database, of course, the database shall have columns. So we are going to create static variables that are going to represent for us column names. So first one, static final string. My first one I'll just call row ID. This one I shall represent for me at the ID column. This shall be my primary key for my database table. Then static final string after row ID, I shall also have another column that I'll call name. Okay, so the header shall be name. So this actually, this is just like a key ID. This is just like a variable just to hold for us the column names. Okay, so that's it. And then lastly, I'll also have some static another static variable right here known as position, and of course maybe tag. Okay, just for the sake of debugging. Now this one I'll just call a DB adapter. This shall be my tag. So that's it guys. These are my columns, these three ones right here. Then after that one, we shall also come and define our DB properties, database properties. This is stuff like the database name and the database version and whatever. So as once more we are going to sort them inside the static variables right here. So static final string, this one I'll call db name. So for my database name, I'll just give it something short that is easy for me to use, like this one. I'll just call it GDB, okay? GDB, grid view DB. So that's it. Then I'll copy this one. We shall also need the TB name, the table name. So I'll copy it, come right here and reuse it. TB name, this one I'll just call GTB, okay? Then of course after that one, we're also going to have static final int for the database version. So I'll call it a DB version, and then I'll give it one. Now take note of the how are they called, the quotation marks, okay? You can take note that I've used single quotation marks and not double. So guys, that's it. Those shall be our properties. Now the next thing, of course, you have to create our SQL statement that shall create for us the database table, okay? Remember, we shall create a table, so let's just create a SQL statement. We shall also store it in a static variable right here. So I'll just call it a create TB. And then this one shall be my stuff. I'll just call it a create table GTB. Okay, this is my table name, ID, integer, primary key, auto increment. So you can see that this one right here, this one shall be our primary key. Okay, yeah, that particular column. Now that's it. Then name text not null. We shall insert name shall be text. Then position text not null. So that is shall be our SQL statement for creating our database table. Then we shall also need a context, and we shall also just come right here and also just SQLite database. We are just going to declare it for now. So guys, that's it for now. The next thing that we're going to do, we are going to create our constructor for this, our DB adapter, and then assign that our context right there. So our constructor, it shall take a context, okay, and assign it right there. So anybody who shall want to use this class to do his database operations, he shall be required to pass the context of the application right there. So we're just going to pass it, and then I'm going to say this this dot c equal to c. That's it. This shall be our context. Now let's just pause for the leave it right there, and then come and create another inner class right here, okay? Now this inner class, our inner helper class, it shall help us to create our database table by executing this our create TB statement. It shall also help us to upgrade our database table. So come and say private static class, I'll just call it DB helper. So it's going to extend of course SQLite open helper. So right here we shall need to override two methods. First, of course, we're going to add our constructor right there. Now the only thing I'll need right here is the context. So I'll get rid of these ones. So we shall have our context right here. Then of course the context, we pass it right there. Then here we're going to pass our DB name, our table name. Here just have null. Then right here our DB version that shall be used. Now that is our database, our table version. So once we've done that one, just hover your mouse right here. We need to implement two methods right here. The onCreate, they shall be called to create our database, and of course the onUpgrade, they shall be used. So the first integer right here, this is the old version of the database. So just mark it old version. This one is the new version. So that's it. What we're going to do right here, inside the try catch block, we're just going to create execute our statement. So just have your try catch block right there. Then what we're going to do, just call db. Remember the db, okay, there shall be pass here, dot exec SQL. Then of course we pass our create table statement. Now guys, that shall create for us our database table. Then we come to the upgrade. What's the matter? Okay, we come to our upgrade. Now here the first thing that I shall want to do maybe is just to log out that you're upgrading our database. So log .w. Then for my tag, this is the tag that I created later earlier on. Then I'll just say upgrading db, something brief that way. Then after that one, of course if you want to upgrade something, first you have to get rid of the old one. So we're going to get rid of the old version, okay, by just dropping the old table, by just dropping it right there. So we're going to say right here a drop table, then the table name, for us the table name is mtb, okay, if exists. So this is the if exists, this is the SQL statement that we're going to do, execute. It shall drop for us our table. Then after that one, of course we're just going to call our own create method, then recreate the table using our new version. So that's it. That shall do for us, that shall upgrade for us our database. Actually I've just messed myself here. No, this one, drop table, if exists, then of course my table is GTB, not MTB. So just change this one. That's it guys, that shall do for us, okay. So this one, this shall be, of course, shall be our helper class. Now the next thing, let's just come right here and just declare it. DB helper, helper. So we shall come right here. We're just going to instantiate it right here. Say helper equal to a new DB helper. DB helper, then we pass the context C. And that's it. So this one shall do for us. Now guys, we are through with creating database. We also defined how to upgrade our database. Now the next thing that we're going to do, we're going to see how to open our database connection, okay. Of course when the user wants to do something, first you have to open the database connection. So very first, let's try to move a little bit faster. So public, this one we're just going to return the DB adapter object, then I'll call it open DB. So what we're going to do right here, we're just going to call DB dot helper, no, DB equal to helper, our helper, okay, then dot get write table database. Remember, we want to write to our database. Get try table database, that shall do for us. Then in fact this one, we're just also going to do it inside the try catch block. So just come right here and bring it right here, then I copy paste this one and bring it right here. Then of course what we're going to do, we're just going to return an instance of this particular class. So return this. Anything that you open, you have to close. We've already opened our database. The next thing is to close it. Now to close it, just come and say public void close. So these methods, you are marking them public because we shall want to call them from our main activity. Then helper.close. And that's how we close our database. So that's it. That is opening and closing. So the next thing after opening, of course we shall want to insert data. We're going to create the method to do that one. Our method shall return along, then add. Now right here we're going to pass the two parameters, first as name, then second one I'll have the position right there. So this one, once more we're going to do inside the try catch block. Sorry, I want to copy paste this one. We're just going to catch our exception and print it out. So that's it. What we're going to do, let me just come right here. If you've not been successful, I just return zero. So here, the first thing that we're going to do, we're going to instantiate content values class. So just come and say a content values that call CV equal to new content values. Then we're going to add data, CV.put. First, of course, is the key. Like for us, we want the name. So we shall pass first the key, which we had identified, which is like the column. Then for our name, of course, is the name that shall be passed right here. Then CV.put. Then again, once more, the next thing that we may want to do is the position. Then we just pass the post right there. So that's it. Once we have it, we're just going to just come and say return db.insert. Okay. Then first, of course, we're going to have there the table name. Remember, table name, not a db name. So after that one, here we're just going to have our row ID. Then for the values, we're going to have our content values object. So guys, that's it. That's how simple it is to insert into our database. Now the next thing that we're going to do, of course, is to retrieve all the data. So we shall come right here and get all values. We shall create a method to do so. So this method shall return a cursor. Now public cursor, I'll call it get all. Let me call it what? Get all names. Let me just call it get all values. With it is names or position. So the first thing, just come right here. Let's just create a string that shall hold our column names. Now I'll call it columns. So right here, of course, the first one is the row ID. The second one is the name. And then the last one is the position. So that's it. Once you have that one, we're going to return our cursor db.query. Okay, then right here, the first thing that we're going to pass is our table name, then of course our columns. Then for these ones, I'll just have them all as null, group by null. These are also having null. That's it, guys. That's it. No, that's it. That is our DB adapter class. This one, as we've said, this one shall get for us all the values from the database. This one shall insert for us. Then the next thing, of course, we shall also open. We also defined how to open. This one shall open for us the database. This one shall open for us, close for us the database. So guys, very first, let's just come to our main activity. The first thing, I'm just going to bring my grid view from XML to code. So first we are going to have the grid view, then we're going to have our edit text. So this one I'll call it name txt. Then we shall also have pause txt. Then I shall also have my buttons. So save button and retrieve button. So we're just going to declare them right there. Then once we come right here, we're going to initialize them. So just come and say, let's start with the gv equal to find view by id, then r.id.gridview1. Then of course we cast it to our grid view. We do the same with our name txt equal to find view by id r.id.name.txt. Then of course we cast it to edit text. So we just do the same with our position txt. So come and say pose txt. This one shall also be pose txt. So we're also going to have our buttons right here. The first one of course is the save button. And then right here we're going to have a save button. Then right here button. So we'll do the same with our other button, which is a retrieve button. So retrieve button, this one right here, retrieve button. So that's it. This shall be our buttons and our edit text. Now the first thing, we shall just come here and get our DB adapter object. So come and say final DB adapter. I'll call it DB equal to new DB adapter. Then we should pass the context. You're going to pass this. So that's it. Then we're going to handle the events for our specific buttons. Now first we shall start with the save. When the save button is clicked, so save dot on click listener equal to new view dot on click listener. Then that's it. What we shall want to do right here, of course, is just to save our stuff. Okay, and remember to save, the first thing that you have to do before you insert into your database, the first thing you have to do is to open your database. So you're going to call db.openDB. Okay, so this one I shall open for us our database. Then down here we shall also close it after finishing everything. So we shall say db.close. That shall close for us our database. Now the next thing of course is to insert, and to insert is simple. We're just going to say db. Actually our insert of course shall return a long. Okay, so we're just going to capture that one. I'll call it long result equal to db dot add. Now for the add we need to pass the name, so we're just going to say name txt dot get text. So this one then we just to string. They shall return for us the value right there. Then we shall also have the pose txt dot get text, and then of course dot to string shall return for us the value inside that particular edit text object. So maybe we're just now we can now just check if it is not successful or not. So I'll just say if result okay is not equal to 0, then we shall know that we've been successful. So what we're going to do, we're just going to clear our name txt and pose txt. Okay, because if it is not equal to 0, then we shall know that we've been successful. Otherwise what we're going to do, we can just display to the user just a toast, just to show him that is failed, that we failed to retrieve data, to insert data. So guys, that's it. That is how we insert our stuff. Then of course you have to remember to close. Then the next thing is to retrieve. Now to retrieve, we are going to handle the retrieve button dot set on click listener equal to new view dot on click listener. So that's it. Now right here of course also the first thing that you're going to do, of course in fact guys, remember we want to retrieve data. So we shall want to first store our data in an array list. Okay, so we're just going to create, we shall be retrieving and adding that data to an array list, and it is that array list that we shall bind to our, using our adapter we shall bind it to our grid view. So this one, let me just call it players equal to new array list. This shall give us our stuff. Now the next thing, we just come, where is it, our retrieve button right here. The first thing, because it is here that we shall be entering our stuff, the first thing that I'll just want to make sure is that I clear that particular array list before we start inserting and filling it with data. Now the next thing, once more we shall first open our db. So db .openDB. That shall open for us our DB. Then we shall retrieve. And we just say DB. We had already specified the method. We had already defined the method to help us retrieve. So I'll just say .getAllValues. This one shall retrieve for us. But remember, it shall be returning a cursor. So that cursor, we shall store it in a cursor object. Then loop through that cursor. So once you have that cursor object, we're just going to loop through it. Okay, and fill our array list. Now just say while c.moveToNext. Then first we're going to get the name. Okay. Now if you want to get the position, you can also just get it, like just say c.getString, then you pass the index for me, which is 1. Of course, if you wanted position, it shall be 2. Then after that one, we're just going to add it to our array list. So players.add, then we're going to add it, that particular name. Now that shall fill for us our array list with data. Then guys, now the next thing, of course, remember what we want to do, we want to set that, fill that data to our grid view. Okay, we want to fill it to this, our particular grid view right here. So what we're going to do, first we're going to create an array adapter object right here, just declare it right here, array adapter, a string, I'll call it adapter. Then we shall come inside our own crate, then we shall instantiate it. So I'll come and say adapter equal to new array adapter. Okay, then of course here the first thing we're going to pass the context, which is this. Then for the resource, we're going to use the android.r.layout.simple. I'll give it simple list item. Okay, then we're going to pass there our data source, which is our players array list. So that one, guys, shall give us the object of the array adapter, which you can just come and come and set to our grid view. So we just come right here now. I'll just come right here now. Then I'll just make sure that I close my db.close. Then I can now come and set that particular adapter. So just come and say gv.setAdapter. GV is our grid view object. Then we set it to adapter. And guys, that's it. That's how we retrieve data from our SQLite database and add it to a grid view. So guys, now we shall just run our project so that we have a look. If we have any error, we shall correct it later on. So guys, if we run the project, this is what you can see. This is what we get. Okay, now take note, if I come click retrieve, our retrieve button right here, retrieve. Okay, you can see the data that we have. You can see it right here. You can see the right last player right here. Now what about if I want to add? For instance, I come here and then type something like, let me type something like this one. Then I click save. Okay, the data gets saved, then it clears the edit text. Now if I come click retrieve, you can see it right here. It is retrieving it actually from the database and populating it. Okay, if I come type something like this one once more, then it saves it. Then if I click retrieve, it retrieves it and display it right here. Now probably let me just show you how to handle the events. Let's just see how to handle the events so that if you want to click one of the items, you can get them. So now guys, to handle the events, just come at the GV, say GV, which is of course our grid view object. Then say dot on item click listener. Then right there, just pass a new adapter view dot on item click listener. Then shall request to add an implemented methods. The only one probably that you're going to need is this pause. Now what you're going to do, just come right here, and then write your toast. Okay, So what you're going to see, you can see, of course, you have an array list. So we just call players, which is our array list. It's a global one. Then dot get, then we pass the position. And case does it, this shall handle for us. Now let's run it once more and have a look. So guys, here you can see our program. Now if I come click retrieve, if I come click retrieve right here, it retrieves and populates it, okay? And now take note that if I come click one of the items, you can see our toast right here, okay? If I come click for instance this one, you can see it right here, okay? So guys, hope you've enjoyed the tutorial. Please, if you have like this video, share it with friends and family, okay? Just follow this guy's advice and subscribe so that you continue receiving tutorial like these ones on a regular basis, okay? You can share it with friends and family. You can leave a comment down below. Would really like to hear from you guys. So guys, take care. I'll catch you in the next tutorial.